All right. Good morning, everybody, and welcome to, let me just set this up properly. Good morning and welcome to our weekly talk show, Let's Chit Chat with Narine Dat. This is a local initiative with a global impact. So this is totally different than our weekly Caribbean Spice radio show. Here in Let's Chit Chat with Narine Dat, we invite community-minded guests where they get the opportunity to share their story and their passion for the community and passion for life in general. And so today, we have a very special guest, a young man by the name of Rahaman. And you are going to get to hear more of him and get to know more about what he's all about, why he's here, and all of that. And so if you have any, you know, comments or anything of that kind, you can always send it to us. Oh yeah, you can send it to us even live on our live feed there. That's okay. Anything of that kind, I do encourage you to share our page and so on, because this is not for entertainment. It's totally different, you know, than our weekly radio show, which is more for entertainment and promote the local artists, obviously. But this is more. It has a lot of richness. All of our conversation that we've had in the past, we've had some really great richness, and today wouldn't be any different. So, Rahaman, thank you so much for taking the time to come by.
I would like to say thank you very much for hosting me. I'm grateful to be here. I'm thankful to have this opportunity, because in life, we have opportunities. We have to take them. We have to grasp upon them, and that's how we grow as individuals, and that's why I'm grateful to have you in my life and many individuals watching this. Thank you so much for being here as well.
Absolutely. Yes. Yeah, so, I mean, just so that our audience, our listeners, I should quickly say hello to Apache Warrior, by the way. Thank you so much, sir, for taking a sneak peek to see what we do here during our chit-chat show here. So thank you. We do appreciate that. Yeah, so I know you were born and raised in Guyana, South America, and in Barbice, right? And not to have any bias or anything of that kind, but I mean, I was born and raised in Barbice, Guyana as well, too, and I think that's one of the reasons why we probably have the connection a little bit there. I know the parents, I know the family, uncles, and so on. I think that's one reason we have those kinds of connection. And I always believe as well, too, that people connect for a reason. Exactly. You know what I mean? And so so why don't you take the time, a few minutes or so, introduce yourself, letting people know who you are. What you do right now. You know, I know you're in school. You can talk about that. We will talk about your little side business thing that you're trying to start off, which is one of the reasons you're here. But we want them to know who you are as well. So definitely. Why don't you take it away?
I always find that it's great to meet new people. And my name, personally, you guys know me, I'm Waheed Rahaman. I'm 18 years old, and I'm currently a university student. And I go to the University of Guelph Humber. I'm studying kinesiology at the moment. And I'm just very, very thankful for everything that I have. And the reason why I am here is because Narine, of course, brought me here. And I'm here to make an impact. And the goal that I set for myself years ago was to help motivate and inspire as many individuals as I can in this world. And it all starts small. You have to start somewhere. You have to start with someone or something. And absolutely. That's how you get there. And I just came here, and I came to do something, to make an impact. And that's it.
Yes. And you brought up a good point. And I always like to, when I have that opportunity, I always like to emphasize on that. You know, I always believe that the biggest project, and I've said it many times before, but I like the idea of saying it again so that people get it. The biggest project usually starts off with the simplest idea. So I don't know of anybody, at least not for me. I didn't wake up one day and then things just happened and so on. You know, it started off with little things. I tried certain things, did not work out so well as planned, and so on. But you always have to keep moving forward, because I think once you keep moving forward, you're going to find your path. The problem is, like, once you stop, you know for sure that you're not going anywhere. All right. And so, so I like the fact that you mentioned that things start with a small, you know, start off small, because I can assure you, in time to come, you're going to remember this conversation. If you came into the studio here in Waterloo, you know, we've had this conversation, and that's how things usually start. Definitely. Yeah. So how is school going for you? I know this is your first year,
yes.
And it's always interesting in different ways, because I've had many friends and so on who started off, you know, first year, trying to, let's say, you know, they were thinking, okay, they want to do computer science and so on.
Yes.
Then halfway through, they switch into something totally different. So what is that experience like for you, going to university now? Is a whole different ballgame. So why don't you share that with us?
Well, university, I have to say, it's literally what you make it. And if you go in and you're very confident about what you're doing, you really do your research beforehand, before actually entering university. I know that sometimes you might find different pathways, different goals, different opportunities there. And you just have to take the opportunity to go after it and take advantage of that. And university for me personally, it's because I manage my time wisely, and I like go out there and I plan my days ahead of time. Mm-hmm. I find that I'm very, very productive throughout the days, and it's not as challenging for me because of the way I plan. So the main thing is plan before, and then you're good to go for that entire week or month or 3 months or 90 days that you have for those semesters.
So do you find that the course load, do you find it's like heavy for you? Like do you find that?
I would say sometimes it
can be, yeah.
Could be, but if you stay on top of things, mm-hmm. then it doesn't have to be.
Yeah, the key point, one of the advice I can give, speaking of that, you know, for me, like if you want to have success, you know, let's say you want to finish off, and I hope you are going to finish off, and I have no doubt you are going to finish off, all right? So let's say you started off, let's say a degree and so on. The key point is to show up in the class every day. I can tell you it helps. Just by going there and just listening to the professors and so on, you gain so much, and you're taking in all of that. You're not realizing, right? If you're not missing classes, if you're doing your assignments, and if you are asking questions for clarification and so on, it becomes easy. I can assure you it's not that difficult, you know, but once but not everybody is that privileged to because some people, you know, they have other things in a way, and they're not able to cope with both pieces. But once you stay focused, managing your time is key. I think things will fall in place. And also I find that once you start off well, you want to maintain that as well too, because it's very motivating as well, knowing that, you know what, I can actually do this. Because I find that during my time, and I'm still taking programs too, you know, because something I kind of enjoy, but I find that I'm stronger in certain areas, and I think we all are that way. You know, when it comes to like, you know, community development, all of those pieces, I champion those pieces, and certain pieces I have to put some extra effort, you know, but that's just the way how things are. But sometimes I'm amazed of myself as well too, because when you realize that, oh, I can actually do this. And keep in mind, we wouldn't always be successful at the very first try. I can tell you that, we wouldn't always be successful at our first try. And if you try something and you realize it's not working out so well, I think that's okay too. So I'm glad that things are going well for you, your school wise and so on. So what made you get into that part of the program?
What made me get into that part is, number one, showing up and doing what I do. I started about 3 years ago lifting weights and going into the gym and trying to help myself. And from there, I found myself, bettering my mind and bettering my body. Mm-hmm. As I live by today, bettering my mind, bettering myself, and bettering my body's mindset, lifestyle. And that has helped me take that to other individuals. Mm-hmm. And really, from there, I found myself choosing a program that in grade 10, I kind of found very, very passionate about. I was like, this program is like something that I want to go into because it offers me knowledge that I'm able to seek and really learn from. Yes.
Yes. And so I like the way you said that. So when you keep in mind, going to college, university, mm-hmm. all of that, it is a huge investment.
It is.
And I'm not talking necessarily about the money and so on. Canada here is not that bad, actually, compared to the States, by the way. Like it's a whole big ball, different ball game there. But I think the time, keep in mind, you're investing, generally speaking, you know, a bachelor's degree is like 4 years. And so you're investing 4 years of your time, you know, going to school, you know, going back and forth, balancing all the different pieces. And so choosing something that fits with you, it's one of the best things you can do for yourself. And it does not matter what that is. And so I end up got into social work, social service type of program, because it fit with me perfectly. And I knew that, because when I made a switch and I got into, you know, social work, social services, I actually enjoy every single day going to school. And whereas I've heard people say, oh, why am I here? You know, they're not showing up,
exactly.
And so on. So choosing that is key. And that relates to job as well too. And I think it all comes, you know, it all related here, because when people go to school, at the end of it all, the idea is to find themselves a job, do something that's meaningful to them, something that doesn't feel like work. And so if you're not taking the program, that you're passionate about, if you're not aligning yourself to do something that you like and enjoy. And I know it might sound a little bit too heavy here, but I can tell you that if you are doing something that you're not happy at work-wise, you are going to be unhappy for the rest of your life. I can tell you that. I can tell you that for sure. And so for me, it's never too late to make any kind of adjustment. And you will know when you go to work, because if you go to work and you're looking at that time,
then you know that, of course, it's not something that you want.
Yeah, for sure.
Mm-hmm. You just have to find that when you find something you enjoy to doing, you can take that and make it something, because the day and age we live in today, there's so much out there we can make happen. And if we don't step outside of our own zone of comfort, then we wouldn't be able to actually find that passion of ours.
Perfect. And I can see why the two of us can get along really, really well, because we really take the life here, you know. And so I hope that you are sharing our page. Please do take the time to share our page, because there's a lot of richness, and really share it, you know, with friends, watch it back. We are going to put it on YouTube as well.
Definitely.
So because there's a lot of rich information here, because keep in mind, the whole idea of this show is to really educate people as well, too. People can learn from each other, you know, and like I said earlier, this show is totally different than our Caribbean Spice radio show. We really want to enlighten people and so on. And in order for us to do that, we have to have enlightened type of people like yourself,
exactly,
who want to kind of do better things for themselves and better things for the community and so on. So what we're going to do, we have lots more to share. Rahaman, my guest here today, is a very passionate young man that I actually was able to see some of those pieces. And usually people reach out to me as obviously, you know, for a variety of different reasons and so on. But this time I end up reaching out to him because I did see something in you. And I can see really great potential in you, and I can see you being somebody, you're going to make a name for yourself. I'm making
Thank
that
you.
Prediction.
Thank you.
Prediction and
exactly.
A new year. You know, I can see that. And, you know, I told you one-on-one before.
You know, one thing I always say is that what you put out there is what you're going to get back from you. So if you are going to give positive energy, the energy that you give out is the energy that you get back.
For sure.
And what you put out there, like I said, is what you get back. So if you feed yourself and you give others positive attitudes, positive mindset, and give them that energy, you'll get that energy back from them. It's all about the energy you absorb in life. And
yes,
as we connected on that basis, we're very connected through that because of our energies. They match, and we feed off each other's energy, and we help each other.
Correct, yeah.
And we motivate each other in that way.
For sure. Yeah, we have lots in common, sure. We are going to take a quick break. And one of the reasons we've chosen to play, you'll notice our instrumental, it's all First Nation related type of music. But we really want to pay respect to our First Nation here in Canada, because the lands and so on, for those
exactly.
of you who know the history and understand the history, the land pretty much belongs to them, you know, kind of thing. I don't want to get into all of that. It's a whole different topic. But we are going to try our best to continue along that path. But before we go for a short break, I would like to say hello to Harry, listening and watching us all the way from the United States. And we all were church members way back in Ghana and so
awesome.
On. Very, very nice people. And they always support whatever I do and so on. I appreciate the fact that they're following along. Romero, I'm happy new year to you, all of you. By the way, happy new year to you.
Happy new year.
And thank you for taking a sneak peek to see what we do. We appreciate that. Vanita, thank you so much as well. And for those of you who are sharing our page, send us your comment and so on. We appreciate that. And that's one of the reasons why we do the show. You're listening to Let's Chit Chat with Narine Dat, with our special guest, Rahaman. We have lots more to share, so make sure you stick around.
Son of Ecuador, Kausai Takarai, Tigramushama, Pinto Tavalo.
In my heart, I have promised you a return one day. Now here I am, I walked, I ran, and I found my way. From the sunshine of God.
All right, so we are back with my guest here, yes. Rahaman. For those of you who happen to tune into us for the first time, this is our new talk show, Let's Chit Chat with Narine Dat. It is a local initiative with a global impact. And so, obviously, you have lots going on. And I know you're starting businesses and so on, all of that, which is great. And we are going to talk and share about that a little bit more towards the end and so on.
Definitely.
But what else you have going on with you? I know you are very active with you take your self-care, I guess I can say. You really take good care of your body, I guess I can
yes.
say. Because the only reason why I say that, because you put clips on an ongoing basis and so on, I can see how passionate you are. So what motivated you, if you don't mind, to kind of get into that kind of fitness piece? And I can see in how you have grown. I've seen it, eh?
I have.
So, yeah. Mm-hmm.
So when I was little, I would say I was very overweight, mm-hmm. which unfortunately, obesity is something that's, of course, a big thing. And when I got a little bit older and I realized, you know what, I need to make this change. And I started going to the gym for a little bit and I was realizing, you know what, this is something I really like to do. And I went out there, I went to the gym, mm-hmm. and I started, of course, when I was 14, 15.
Mm-hmm.
And from there, I found myself starting to lose weight. And when I lost all the weight I did, I actually lost about 50 to 60 pounds because
mm-hmm.
I was very heavy. I was 180. Maybe at the age of 13, and I was pretty heavy. But yes, it's people say it's when you are little and you're growing up, you have that you lose weight.
You call
as
it
you,
baby fat.
Baby fat, yes. But when I lost all that weight, I also became very cautious of the way I ate and everything. And that also was a negative in a way because I lost too much weight. Mm. And that's when I found myself lifting weights because in order to build back that amount of muscle and that amount of body weight that I needed, I had to build on muscle. So I started lifting and I did some weight training exercises, hypertrophy work and powerlifting. And from there, I found myself really being passionate about it. So it took 4 years to do all that. And I post every day online because I want people to see that anyone can do anything they set out for. And no matter what age you are, you can do it. Doesn't matter. Yes.
Yes, the stuff that, for me, the way I see it, anything you do, you have to have some sort of passion and motivation, obviously. It doesn't matter what that is. But this whole weight thing and going to gym and exercise and have this routine and be conscious, as to what you eat and so on, is not an easy thing, eh?
Oh, definitely.
Because,
not.
I mean, and I hope nobody take me personally. We do a freestyle show here. We are very open here. I've known many, many people and, who will have let's say an exercise machine at home and all of that. But having it and using it is two different things. And because people, I always give one example. When people say to me, I have a big snowblower and all of that. But if you're not cleaning your snow, so that snowblower becomes useless, right? And so just like anything else, so if you have an exercise machine, if you're not using it and so on, it becomes useless, really. And just anything else, our capabilities, if we have some sort of capability to do something and we just have an idea, and that's just an idea, but if we're not really, doing anything with it, kind of thing. So I admire that part of you to kind of have that dedication and so on, because, I've heard stories from people get started, they're seeing really good results and stuff of that kind, but sometimes I'm not sure what's happening, and then it kind of fall through the cracks. I've seen that
exactly.
as well, too.
It's like any skill, you use it or you lose it.
Yes,
that's it.
For sure. So, I hope personally that you will keep that motivation, because what I'm seeing from you is lots of motivation. Eh? Yes. And the thing, if I'm not mistaken, you are the youngest one in your family.
Yes, I'm actually the youngest one. I learn everything from my siblings.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, I happen to be the youngest one too.
What a coincidence, I tell you.
Are you, you don't have to share this if you don't want to, but are you the first generation to go to university?
Yes, I actually am.
Yeah. Same here as well.
That is what drives me to keep going.
Yeah. Yes, I think it's very motivating. And also what I find is that once you finish, once you graduate, it will be motivating for the other siblings as well too.
Yes, the generations to come.
Yes, they're going to be happy to see you be the first one to walk on that stage.
Yes.
And I can tell you, once you walk on that stage, it's, you know that it's not like you're comparing yourself with other people, but it's just that it puts you that over that, it gives you that extra edge and that it give you know you
that
it,
confidence.
Oh, that confidence.
Yes.
And you really feel good knowing that, you know what, you've done it. Right? And so I wish you well with that for sure.
Thank you.
That's great. I kinda suspect that you probably are the first one to kinda take that step there, which is extremely difficult to do. Because usually people will see what other people are doing, or they are going to get mentoring from the older siblings or family members and so on. But being the youngest one and being able to break all of those barriers and say, well, nothing is going to stop me.
Exactly.
I'm going to go to university.
Exactly.
I want to do this. I think it is amazing. So that is a really beautiful thing. I'm very happy for you. I can tell you that. So you're going to school full time. During the break, we're talking, you working,
yes.
You are also starting, I saw you had some private conversation.
Yes.
You started, and we are going to give you more details and so on, but you started a little small business.
Small business investment.
You know, so which is a beautiful thing. I remember when I was in high school, I actually, I graduated here, locally here, at KCI.
I do know that.
All right. And so there was one fella, he was 18 years old, and he came to give us a presentation in the class. And he said to me, he started a business, and it worked really well for him. He started a vending machine business. And then now he's grown, he's doing other stuff and whatnot. So you start a business. Why don't you tell us about a business that you started? Why you started? Why don't you take it away?
So actually, it's kind of more like two businesses. The first one is just for healthy lifestyle. It's just a beverage it helps so many individuals through the impact of what that beverage has inside of it. And I always leave it as a little bit of a something for you to find out and reach out to me, because sharing everything, I want people to connect and come to me as well and ask me about it. So it's that one is more of a healthy lifestyle. You go out there, you put something in your body. And like I said, what you feed your body and mind is when you're going to get out of your body and mind. And I gave you this example when we first met, is you have a software, right? That is everything, your cells, and your hardware is your entire body. So if you feed your software with things that will benefit it, then the hardware will work up to its highest standards. But if you're feeding your software with something that is not so beneficial, your cells, for example, then your hardware is going to be affected through diseases, through sickness.
And it cannot be repaired, man, in some cases.
It could possibly, but
I know.
Definitely. But,
yes.
But for sure, it can be repaired, but it can't be repaired due to the damage that you do. So whatever you feed yourself is what you're going to get. And the second one is just financial, like financial fitness, helping people through educational tech platform. And that itself is making the money that I do and then putting it into investments and helping grow at a young age will benefit me in the future to come.
For sure.
Because when you invest in that and you continue to invest, you're able to help so many more people and reach out. And I always say this, that money is not everything, but money gives you the opportunity to do so much. It doesn't bring you happiness, but it can bring you freedom and the happiness that you can get through money.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. So I like the way you said it. Sure enough, money is not everything. There's no question about that, because I work for money, by the way, but at the same
Everybody does, right?
And that's one reason we get up in the morning, we go to work and so on. What I'm trying to, although money is not everything, money is still important, because if it wasn't for money, I guess you could have not put yourself into university, for example.
Exactly, and I thank my mom for that because she's helped me so much through that. She's the one that actually pushed me. She's like, you got to go to university, you got to make it happen. And I've listened to her all my life, and I've come to the place I have been right now.
Amazing. Yeah. So I know we're going back and forth here, but it's all related here. So did you receive any scholarship at all? We got a lot of scholarships.
I actually entered university, I did receive a scholarship high marks.
Good.
Awesome.
Because there are, sometimes I don't want to lose it from great opportunities. Maybe we'll talk more too, but there are millions of dollars in scholarship that people are not aware of. So maybe something you should dig into more as well to their last. It looks like... you started off this business because you see some potential there, but also I can see the passion.
Yep.
Passion. It's all like come together. It's like, you know, it's the kind of stuff you enjoy doing. Mm-hmm. You can see physical benefit, mental benefit, all of those pieces, spiritual benefit.
When you invest in something you're passionate about, then it'll just continue to go out there and share it to others and grow it.
Yeah. Yes. And so we are going to give this information at the end, but if people want to get a hold of you, you know, they want to, let's say you've said something here that really
draw their attention.
How
can they reach out to me?
I'll get to you. Why don't you share some information?
You can get my
email or whatever.
You can get my link on Facebook right now on the live, or when you're watching this, of course, on YouTube. I do have my own YouTube channel as well.
Good.
I do that to inspire others, help them, but also email. My email will also be linked in my Facebook. So everything is through Facebook. And then everything you'll see there. That's how you actually found me on Facebook.
Yes, for sure. Yes. And so it's amazing how the social media thing works, right? Because people share. And speaking of sharing, like whatever people share on social media and Facebook, it really determines who they are.
Exactly. I always say that.
There's no question about that, right? Because, I mean, if you really want to know know something about somebody, I mean, it's not about judging people necessarily.
Nope,
judging.
Definitely not.
You know, because as human beings, we all judge. It's just a natural thing for do.
Yes.
I do it. We all do it. But I try to be very conscious about it, and I guess I've improved a lot.
Yes.
I say, I shouldn't be doing that, you know? But no question about it. Whatever we post on Facebook or any other social media platform, it determines who we are. And because... the stuff that you were posting, it made sense to me. And the stuff that you were posting, it relates to what you wanted to do. And the passion there. Sometimes they say a picture can speak 1,000 words, right?
Definitely.
And so you can see that passion, you can sense that passion. And you're posting, what I find, it is very consistent in terms of the stuff that motivates you and like to do, and that's who you are.
That's what I use in my life. Consistency is key to anything you need and anything you want.
Yes, for sure. So you don't post like random stuff on there. And I'm not saying anything is wrong. So we're just having a conversation here. You just determine who we are as a person. That's all. So that doesn't make him or myself any better than anybody else. Just determine who we are.
Yeah, because you lead the life you want and live the life that you want to live, of course.
For sure. So if you happen to just join us, you're listening to our new talk show, Let's Chit Chat with Narine Dat. We have a special guest here, Rahaman, a very inspiring young man who shared so much within the past half hour. So what we're going to do, we're going to take a quick break. And we're going to come back and we're going to share more. You're going to get to hear more about him. And I have one or two simple questions for him as well, too, because I'm a job developer. And so I always like to know anything that has to do with job, creation, job or, schooling and all of that, career development and so on. I'm very interested and want to hear, people's perspective on that as well,
Definitely.
So if you are out there as well, too, let's say you're looking for work, you want to advance your career or anything of that kind, do reach out to me. Doesn't matter where you live, which part of the world you live, reach out to me, and then I will kind of connect you with somebody who can help you along. Because as we were talking about earlier, if you're working in a field that you're not happy in, your life will be miserable for the rest of your life, for sure. I always like to re-emphasize that. For sure,
before we go into the break, I just want to say a quote by Gandhi himself, of course. He said, I was reading this the other day, you find yourself in the service of others. So when you help someone, you actually find your own self, and it'll benefit you as well as benefit them. And that's what it's about. Human nature and human beings should be together like this.
For sure. And that's what the world needs right now, to tell you the truth.
For sure, definitely.
I find that day by day, we are all separating ourselves from each other for simple things. I find that we are competing against each other and all of these types of things. I think we need a little bit more of togetherness, unity, yes, type of thing. And speak of that, and I think that's one of the reasons why we do things like our simple Caribbean Dreams concert. One of the reasons, I don't do it for money, by the way, one of the reasons why we do that show is to really bring the community together underneath one roof where we can celebrate diversity, we can celebrate life, kind of thing. It's a very open, diverse type of thing, you know, and it's a really good opportunity for people to connect as well, Joe. I actually, one thing I'm very proud to say, speaking of that, because earlier we were talking about how the biggest things usually start out with the simplest idea.
Simplest start.
And one girl who I'm happy to say, like she who performed, she performed at her Career Dreams concert locally here, and I was watching her views, and she's gotten millions of views. Millions of views.
Something small like that.
Yeah, millions of views. And so I was lost for words. And one of the guys who performed as well too, he lives locally here in Kitchener. He actually, at that time, Justin Bieber was not known. You know, he was not known. And so that fella performed on her show. And he did a competition with Justin Bieber. And he won over Justin Bieber. But Justin Bieber was not known at that time. And keep in mind, it's a whole different thing when it comes to race as well, and definitely, all of that. I want to get into all of that. But, you know, but so all of that we have done. And one fella who I remember came to our show, the Caribbean Dreams concert, that is, and he was just a small child, and his mother was performing, a professional reggae singer. So she was performing, and he was crying, wanted to go on that stage to perform. He was not on that scheduling, and it was up to me to make that determination, really, because it was me who put together the program. We wanted everything to go with a nice flow, and I actually changed it right on the spot. I let him go there on the stage. He played some piano that made him really feel good, because you need confidence as well to go on stage and so on. Definitely. And so, and I can still remember there was one fella, he came and said to me, he said, "Narine, what are you doing? Like, why are you putting a kid to perform on the stage?" Because he was not able to see the bigger picture. And that fella today, he is actually performing professionally internationally. And in fact, in 2007, we brought him back on that show, on the Caribbean Dreams, right here in Kitchener, and we honor him with the Active Vision Award, because we were celebrating our 15 years. And so those little things can turn out to be really, really big things. And in fact, on this stage, he mentioned, and I have the video to prove it, and he mentioned that he showed appreciation for us giving him that opportunity to perform. We could have easily said, "Oh, we're not going to bother. Like, we don't have time for that, you know, stuff of that kind." Because anytime we do a show, it's about the artists. That's one of the reasons we don't serve alcohol at our show, because we are not focusing on that. We're focusing on the artists. We really want to maximize the potential of these people. And we've done really well doing that. I'm very happy to say that. Yes. So we're going to take a quick break. And I just thought I'd mention that, because sometimes things slip through my mind and I don't get to say it. So we're going to take a quick break. We're going to be right back. You're listening to Let's Chit Chat with Narine Dat. We are here with our very special guests, Rahaman. Very happy to have you here. And I hope that this will inspire you as well to move forward. And I know that there's nothing will hold you back, really, because at the end of the day, it's up to us, you know, to determine the things that we want, and the choices and the decision that we make in life will determine who we are. Exactly. And what we will become.
And
yes. And you have that. And if you keep it going, you will just be laughing. And I'll be happy to see that. All right, we'll be back in a few minutes.
Regálate tu orejita, tu corazón.
All right. So we are back. I'm chit-chatting with our special guest, Rahaman. We are basically friends now. I mean, I've known him since when he was a small kid. I remember when we were talking about the Caribbean Dreams concert, your sister and so on, they were part of it in helping along and stuff of that kind. And if I'm not mistaken, I think they probably at times brought you along because you were small at that time carrying along, because we've been doing this show obviously for about 17 years now. So that's a long time, you know. So on this show, what I normally do, we want to make sure that we, I mean, we have lots of negativity, you know, in this world. It is not uncommon for us to focus our time, energy on negative things and so on. But, you know, this is a new year and so on. So we really want to put a new spin, you know, to things. And so if I was to ask you, what is one thing, you can share more than one if that's okay with you too, that you are very much grateful for, what will that be?
I am grateful for, well, there's many things, but the number one thing has to be, of course, being able to have the functioning body I do. Like I said, your body is what will help you spread awareness, do many things, and you just got to be grateful for the little things, because those little things add up to all the big things you have. And if you're not grateful for the little things you have now, then how will you expect to be grateful for the ones that are coming in the future? And I am grateful for, of course, being able to talk, walk, speak, move my fingers. I always say that because the little things mean everything at the end of the day.
Yes. And, you know, I'm so glad that you say that, because so if I understand you correctly, and if I was to summarize what you've just said, you are very much appreciative of life itself.
Yes.
You know, the fact that you can have a conversation, the fact that you can hear, you can read, all of that, are you appreciative of those things? And you know, you kind of nail it there for me. I'll tell you why, because it's not uncommon if I have conversation, not necessarily on the radio show, you know, for the new year, for example, you know, if people have New Year's resolution and so on, there's nothing wrong with
nothing
that.
Wrong
I
with
think
that,
it's totally
course.
Fine to take things to the next level, advance your life, move forward and so on. But, you know, but most of the time people will forget to, you know, take care of themselves or appreciate, you know, that, you know, life itself, appreciate,
exactly.
You know, I actually met somebody, speaking of that, the fact that you mentioned about the body and so on, I almost embarrassed myself yesterday. And as a social worker person, I'm supposed to know these things, but sometimes it just slips through the cracks. Sometimes I wasn't at work at that time. Anyways, I went out, and I saw this lady and with this stroller and with this little kid. And then I said to her, oh, I didn't realize we could have brought kids here, that I would have brought my daughter as well too. And then she said to me, no, that her child is 20 years old. But she obviously has some challenges and stuff of that kind. But you can tell, right? And so that was a lesson I learned
exactly.
For sure, right?
And those little things, like I said, you got to be grateful for that.
You know, but you know, and it goes to show, and I was so, and I met her for the first time, but I ended up sharing this story with a few people yesterday, because the person who I never met was so warm and welcoming, and the smile, and I can see, despite the fact that she has, a child with challenge, that did not hold her back from
exactly.
doing her normal things and really explore and really kind of enjoy life. And I said to myself, wow, like, what a
exactly.
good example.
And if nothing brings you motivation, exactly. just look at people that have challenges and be motivated, because they're out there living life and continuing to live, and we have so much. And we can be thankful for that. Like, we have to be at the end of the day.
So, thank you for that.
You're welcome.
So this is a new year. And so, first of all, I know many of you, you know, when I started the Caribbean Spice Radio Show over 15 years ago, and so on, I always take the time to respond to every single message and email and so on. And I always say today, you know, say on during the show that you know, we try our best to respond to everybody and so on, but I have to tell you, it's good and bad in both ways, I've gotten so many messages for this new year that I was unable to respond to everybody, and I felt so bad, right? And I was trying my best to give the thumbs up and all of that. And then I end up doing the thumbs up, because I just couldn't type like a whole thing and kind
exactly.
of do all of them, because like so many people, which I was very excited and happy about. And one fella, a good friend of mine, I'm hoping he was being sarcastic. He said to me, he said, "What, you don't know how to type anymore?" Because I just gave him the thumbs up. What I was trying to do, I was trying to acknowledge the fact that he took the time to wish me well and so on. But, you know, the kind of, when you have so many followers and so on, you know, sometimes it's just impossible. But I can assure you, I want to take this time to let you know that I appreciate the fact that you took the time to wish me well. And in return, I would like to wish you well as well. And this is a new year. It's always exciting, obviously. You know, sometimes not all of us have had the opportunity to enjoy, you know, the kind of things that we were hoping for and so on. And keep in mind, you know, that's the past, right? If, for those of you who've had a good year, hopefully it continues that way. But let's say you had a challenging year, you know, you just have to move forward. I don't really like the word hope, because for me, hope is not a plan, right? Having a plan, as you mentioned earlier, is a better thing to do. But, you know, but being hopeful and being positive is okay too. But I never like that word hope. So for this new year, what is that you're hoping to accomplish for this new year? Because I know that there are a few things I'm really, and I can see this year being an extremely good year for me. I'm there, and so they're going to be something extremely special that I would like to share, not now, but in a few weeks. Keep tuning to us. I will probably take it to social media or this kind of platform, because that's something special. I would like to share something that I can see this year being a really, really good year for me. So I'm very excited about that. But what is it that you're hoping for yourself for this new year? You know, what is it you're hoping to accomplish?
There's so much to do in this year. There's so much to accomplish. I would say number one is taking action, because you can say so many things, but if you don't do them, then that's two different things. You can say it, but if you don't do it, then you have to take that action. So what I really want to accomplish this year is just continue to help more people. Like, I've helped a lot of people last year, but this year I want to help many, many more, whether that be maybe financially, physically, emotionally, mentally, and just helping them. Like, that's the goal in my life. I've always said I want to help, motivate, inspire as many individuals as I can in this world. And it all starts small, and then it goes bigger. That's how you get started. And that's just the goal this year, is continue to help more people and continue to better my mind, better my body, and better my lifestyle. So that's the main thing. Yes.
Good. So for those of you who actually have any sort of comments and so on, you can actually you can put it on the live feed. If it's something that you want to share with other people to see, that's fine. The alternative way to do that, you can also email us at mcnarine@hotmail.com. That probably will be a good thing. And even after the end of the show here, do take the time to share. You can send us your questions or anything of that kind. You know, any kind of feedback will be great, because one thing I can tell you, feedback, I don't ever take it personally, because that's how I grow as a person. Because your opinion is your opinion. At the end of the day, it's up to me to use that and tweak things as we go along. So you don't have to, if you have any recommendation for us or anything of that kind, you just let us know, and we'll kind of make changes if we need to. But any kind of feedback, very, very important for us and things of that kind. But as I said earlier, the whole purpose of the show is to really bring inspiring people like this young man here to really share their story, their passion for life in general. If that's
sharing is caring.
That's right. That's one of my favorite things most recently. Yeah. So we have a few minutes here, and this is a freestyle show, and because this is the first show for this year, you know, our new show, that is, Let's Just Chat with Narine Dat, we have to acknowledge a few people here. You know, Faz listening locally here in Kitchener. Thank you so much for taking the time to tune into us. Do you guys have a relationship here?
Yes, my brother-in-law.
Your brother-in-law, right? Okay, yes. So yeah, I know the fella really well. I know the parents, amazing people, by the way. Eh? Yes, that's what I thought. I wasn't sure. Lachman, thank you so much for taking the time to tune into us. We appreciate that. Omesh Singh, from Omesh Jewelry, thank you, sir, for taking a sneak peek. Very good gentleman. He's a fella that sings and so on. He's from the Wave Band.
Yes, I know him.
Yes. A very awesome. good gentleman. Actually bought off him many years ago. I don't wear a gold chain. I bought off of him. as I get older, I strip off those things, and so I don't care. I don't have watch and stuff anymore. But I will have to take it to him for a little bit of repair. Maybe that's an opportunity for me to go and say hello to him. Kind of thing. Very good gentleman. He always takes a sneak peek, and in the past he's been very supportive of us and stuff like that. And because when we started the show, actually, or Caribbean Dreams, many years ago, over 17 years ago, I remember Miss Singh, he did sponsor, you know, a flyer, because at that time we were knocking on doors and to get people to help along. He offer door prizes and stuff of that kind. But speaking of door prize, one of the reasons why I don't offer door, we don't necessarily do door prize anymore. The whole idea is to focus on the artists, people performing. We want to see them grow. So I don't worry too much about all of that. In fact, when I put it on social media that our next show is on June the 1st, there was one gentleman, he reached out to me right away and said, "Ryan, we'd love to give you some door prizes." But as much as we appreciate his kindness wanting to do something like that, that's not the whole purpose of the show. I want people to come to the show because they're passionate, you know, to come and support what we do, kind of thing. And so that's what we do different. And there are so many shows happening in this region of here, Waterloo here, but it is ours has a uniqueness to it, and that's something I'm very proud to say, because we started from scratch, not knowing where it's going to take us and so on. But we have done
very started.
Yes. We started, and then obviously we've had lots of stumbling blocks in a way. We started a show, actually, I'm not sure if I mentioned it on the show here before, but I think I've told you before, we started a show calling the Guyanese event kind of thing. And then we named it the Indo-Caribbean Dreams. And then we realized we want to broaden it, I think I told you.
Yes.
And then we removed the Indo, we call it the Caribbean Dreams, because the whole idea is to be as inclusive as possible kind of thing. Yeah. So any special message you want to say, Joe? I know it's new year. I'm sure there's so many people obviously watching. You want to say a special message in terms of the new year?
I just want to say continue to work hard this year. It's a brand new year. So you have, not 365 days, but 363 days now to just go out there, do what you want, do what you love. And if you're not doing what you love, try to find some passion or hobby that you do love to do. And you can obviously make that something if you want to. But I just want to say I wish you all the best. May you prosper this year, and may you continue to be happy, bring happiness, and be positive into this world.
Yes. So that's a good message from a young man. Because you really have to, the key point, keep in mind, when you wake up in the morning, you have to do something with your time and life.
Exactly.
And there, I think I share with you personally, but let's share it to the world now. I always ask myself two questions every day. The first thing when I wake up in the morning, apart from thanking God and whatnot to live to see another beautiful day, I always ask myself, like, what is it that I want to accomplish today? Every single day I ask myself that question, because it's up to me to go and get these things done, right? It's not going to happen if I just stepped on the back, right? So I ask myself that question, what is it that I want to accomplish? And at the end of the day, I ask myself another question. And that next question is, what is it that you actually accomplished? Right, so I will reflect back on that day and see, did I actually accomplish the stuff that I wanted to accomplish? And sometimes I do, sometimes I don't, and that's okay too. But for me, as long as I give it my all and give it my best shot, that's a beautiful thing. And I would encourage you to do those little things, those bits and pieces, so really maximize your potential. And you know, as much as I would love to have millions of dollars in my life, and so I'm not the one of those. I'm rich at heart.
That's it.
Right. So I don't have like millions of dollars and stuff of that kind, you know. But one thing I can tell you, that if you utilize the resources you have, whether that be inspiring people, your own potential, all of that, your own resources, little resources you have to maximize your potential. That is a beautiful thing. You cannot wait, until you retire to enjoy life. You cannot wait until you have $1 million before you start to enjoy your life.
Or wait until the next vacation to be happy. Oh. Being happy, it starts right now.
So being happy is, you know, I remember there was one when I went back to Guyana many years ago. There was one gentleman, he said something that made a lot of sense to me. He asked me, where is the beautiful place you've ever been to? Right? And so, I mean, I was younger then too, you know, I didn't know as much, you know, and I wasn't fully grown, you know, there yet in that sense. So I was like, really had to think and try to give him, you know, one or two special places and that I went to and so on. And he said to me, you know, the best place, you know, will be where you are at right now, right? Because that moment, I guess what he was trying to say is that you don't have to wait to go to that special place. Okay, I want to go to, you know, to like say Niagara Falls, I want to go to Disneyland or whatever the case may be. You want to enjoy that moment every day. And so that's one of the reasons we were talking about enjoying the job that you're doing, right? Try a way to enjoy the job you're doing. And if you find that it's not working out for you, it's probably a good sign for you to really consider different opportunities and so on. Speaking of that, I can actually help you with that. I'm a job developer, by the way. It doesn't matter where you live, you connect with me and I will connect. If you live locally here, we can really definitely meet one-on-one. But if you live out of the area, you know, we'll connect you with somebody who can kind of, you know, help you along to take that next step. Because, you know, obviously we... Many people that I'm aware of, especially immigrants and so on, they've accepted a job because obviously, you know, they have bills to pay and all that, and kind of more like a survival job and so on. But if you're looking, if you know your potential, if you know always, you know, wanted to do something more meaningful and different, I would encourage you to reach out to me. We can have that little chit chat and we can see how we can move you along. And we've had a lot of success to really take people to the next level. And the program, the service that I offer, by the way, through my job, is free, by the way, so I'm not trying to make money off of you and so on. I actually, you know, it's a government-funded program kind of thing, so we will be happy to see where we can guide you through and kind of help you along, because we want you to be happy, because I know the difference of working, you know, at a job that
getting by just for the paycheck.
And doing something that you're really passionate about, I've seen both before. I understand both. I've made career change and stuff that kind. And so and that's one reason I became a job developer. Really working in social services because I understand it. I've seen it and I would like the same for you, really.
And so, I find that like the people that are most passionate, like I said again with what Gandhi said, is you find yourself in the service of others. And the people that go out there and help people put themselves out there, they find themselves much more happier and passionate about what they do because they're around individuals, they're around people, and that's where they get their energy from.
For sure.
That's where you get passion.
For sure, sure. And everybody, and coming, you know, having a social work background, one thing I can tell you is that everybody, it does not matter of your academic background, your social status, nothing of that kind. Everybody has some sort of potential. I can tell you that. Your potential wouldn't be same as mine and vice versa. Mine, yours wouldn't be, it wouldn't be the same is what I'm trying to say. But everybody has that potential and that that the inside power. But you have to dig deep into yourself to find out what that is. And dig deep because there's something there. You know, you will know, you know, you have to, you know, dig deep. And once you find that, you know, whatever that is.
Upon it.
Yes, you really want to take opportunity of that and really, you know, that's the most valuable gift that you have. And you have to figure out, because I wouldn't know who you are as a person. I mean, I can help you coach along and talk like that, kind of help you move forward, right? That's what I can do. But you will know more of yourself. Like once you dig deep, you know, some people are passionate about music and so on, right? And you can see some people have done really well. That's because they're extremely passionate and they know how to kind of massage it really to kind of really make it work for them. And I mean, not everything will work for you. And some people, it takes a little bit longer time to figure out. And I'm glad that you pretty much, if I was to speak on your behalf for just a moment, I think you have found yours at an early age. And the earlier you find that, the better it is. And I think I found mine too at an early age. I knew when I was in primary school, I was able to really think outside of the box, and I was able to kind of see with a third eye. And I remember somebody said to me, Narine, what do you mean you see with a third eye? Do you see dead people here? Which I think I have told you as well.
Yes, you did.
But basically, I'm able to see things that people cannot see. And so, and we can, you know, see potential, you know, you don't do things just for the temporary thing. And this come back to our show as well, too. Like, you know, many people who come on our Caribbean Dreams concert, for example, if they're coming looking to get paid and they have no talent, they're looking at short term. right? But if you're looking at the bigger picture, that you're coming along, you are giving to the community, you're gaining and all of that, and you look in the big picture, because we have proof to show that people who perform on our show are now performing professionally, making lots of money, by the way. And not me, but I'm very happy for them. So looking at the big picture, maximizing your potential is a beautiful thing. I should quickly say hello though to Naresh Jagdeo, sir. Thank you so much for taking the time to take a sneak peek. JP, Suku, thank you so much overall, sir. Taking a sneak peek. We appreciate all of that, obviously. And so we really are coming to the end of the show here. So why don't you take 30 seconds to say what you want to say? But I appreciate that you took the time to come here.
Yes, I'm thankful to be here.
We will be happy to have you back again sometime in the future. We'll meet, obviously, you know, after the show and stuff of that kind. But if there's any way I can help you move forward, you know, in life or anything of that kind, I'll be happy to do that. It was a pleasure having you here.
Thank you so much. What I just want to say is when you said about, like, vision and everything and going beyond, you just gotta, I just want to end this off, of course, by saying what you envision is what you get, and you just gotta keep working towards that. It's just like anything. You gotta go after it, you gotta keep going, and you're gonna keep climbing up and up and up, and that's how you get to where you want to get to. So you gotta continue to work hard, do what you want, and love the life you live, because it's the only life you have at this moment.
Fantastic. So on that note, both of us would like to thank you for tuning in to our weekly Let's Chit Chat with Narine Dat talk show. Do check out our page, our Facebook page, to get a sneak peek of our guests coming next week. We have lots in store for you, so I'll see you next week. Have yourself a good
one. Take care. Thank you so much.
Tout ce temps perdu.